Hi everyone and welcome again to pilotclimb.com. In today's video I'm gonna practice the go around in the simulator. Okay, at the moment we are on downwind of the airport of Tenerife South, where I've been flying for more than 11 years, and I'm just practicing the go around the simulator because I can tell you that for me, after flying for 11 years the Boeing 737, it's quite difficult. It's a challenge thing, you know, it's a challenge thing to perform an appropriate and very precise go around in the simulator, because of the switches that I had to push that are not in the same position as the real plane, and on top of that the maneuverability of the aircraft is completely different. Okay, so sometimes if you are new it's a lot easier to get used to a simulator, for example, but for me that I've been flying for many years, the Boeing 737, I'm trying to get better on this go around and approach, okay? Because then my plan is to start doing as well live, where you can actually, we can actually interact, but I want to have a good level if we have to perform a go around and approach. So in today's video, I'm just gonna practice the go around. We are on the base, we are at 200 knots. It's a very windy day. As you can see, we've got 32 knots in here. We've got 32 knots tailwind, okay? So let's fly the first approach. I'm just gonna select flap 5. So I'm gonna set flap 5, slow down to 180 knots in here, and try to keep 25 degrees of bank angle in 2,000 feet. Okay, then at 2,000 feet we're gonna intercept the localizer and the glide slope, and then we're gonna go all the way down to the threshold or on 07 in Tenerife. You will see that the wind is very windy today, and then we perform the go around. Okay, so we go back to the 2,000 feet, slow down to 180 knots. 25 degrees of bank, that all seems perfect. So that's Tenerife South in front of us. That area there is called Las Americas and Los Cristianos. Here we go, 180 knots is coming, that's beautiful. And we've got 2,000 feet. Perfect. Final approach course is 0.74, that's all great, so I need to keep 180 knots, so accelerate a little bit. And then as you can see on the right there, we've got the airports already. Alright, the glide slope is already alive, 180 knots, that's all great. And I'm trying to keep 2,000 feet, precisely. Right, 180 knots. So once we get established on the glide slope, okay, the localizer is alive. Once we get established on the glide slope, we lower the gear down the flaps, we put the flaps 15 and we do the checklist, okay? Here we go, the run is in front of us, and I'm trying to get established on the localizer, keeping 2,000 feet for minutes. Sorry, 2,000 feet the altitude. Beautiful. All right, so we've got the glide slope is coming, gear down, we put the flap 15, we slow down to 170 knots now. Our V-fly, so the speed that we're going to maintain on final approach is going to be 150 knots, okay? So we got start switches are continuous, speed breaker, arm and green lights, landing gear is down to green, auto brake, we've got off, we keep it off, okay? There is no reason to do anything, because we're not going to land anyway. And that's it, basically. And then we can set flap 30 now. There we go. So we're approaching 150 knots. I had a little bit of power. So we've got 32 knots, mostly headwind, okay? Okay, the go around for with a 737, okay, we need to push Toga, and I made a separate video about Toga. It's gonna be Toga go around thrust 15, set go around thrust. With a positive area of climb, we set the gear up, okay? We wait until 400 feet, then we check what roll mode we've got, but it's gonna be in our case nothing, because I'm flying with flatterators off and everything. And then we can retract the flaps after 400 feet. We level off at 2,000 feet, and then we do another approach, okay? That's our goal for today. So I'm keeping high on the speed. We've got 156. We want to keep 150. The glide slope is there. Very good. Everything is fine. Flat 30. Beautiful. Okay, we've got an airplane on the runway. Okay, the airplane is on the runway. Okay, it's vacating. So let's say it's not vacating now. So we are approaching the threshold, and we're gonna perform a go around. Okay, it's going to be go around, thrust 15, side go around thrust, positive 8, gear up. Here we go. We maintain 15 degrees of pitch altitude. There we go. Beautiful. 700 feet, which is 500 feet above the ground. We go flap 5. We can tune the radio from its approach, but in our case there is nothing. 1,000 feet, we start a right turn, 25 degrees of bank, and then we lower a little bit the nose. Okay, we want to keep 1,000 feet per minute at this part because we are approaching 2,000 feet per minute. Here we go, flap 1. Beautiful. 25 degrees of bank, 1,000 feet per minute roughly, and then flaps up. Flaps up, okay, we get ready for the level off at 2,000 feet. So 210 knots, we want to keep 210 knots during the missile approach. So I start to decrease the power a little bit. And we are approaching the 2,000 feet. And we go into downwind and we perform another approach. Here we go, we've got 2,000 feet there, reduce the power a little bit. Because on the Boeing 737, since it has got the engines up below the wings, when you reduce the power, okay, when you close the thrust levers, the aircraft actually will pitch down. Okay? So when you want to level off, sometimes the only thing you have to do is just to close a little bit of power, okay? Just to decrease the power, okay? Just to close the thrust levers. And that will give you a pitch down moment already, okay, that allows you to level off like in this case, okay? So now 254 on the track, which is our downwind, and we keep 210 knots, 254, and then we do another approach. Beautiful, 220 knots, 2,000 feet. So let's start to extend the flaps to 5 and slow down to 180 knots. So 5.5 knots. Okay, let's start right now. 25 degrees. We keep 2,000 feet from 2,000 feet in the altitude, okay? And we slow down to 180 knots. Very good. That's gonna be the last one, guys, okay? So we perform another go around and that's it, okay? So it is very important that you actually check the 15 degrees of pitch, that we've got the thrust that is in there during go around, okay? And then once you have the positive rate of climb, that we actually retract the gear, okay? That's why we've got two pilots on the flight deck, because one pilot is flying the plane, the other one is making sure that the pilot that is flying the plane is not making any mistake or is not forgetting anything. And vice versa, okay? So 2,000 feet, 185 knots, everything is great. Good. Beautiful. Keep 2,000 feet, 2,000 feet in there. So I'm gonna continue turning because, as you can see from outside, okay, we are quite high. So I'm gonna start descend visually, okay, and get established on the localizer, okay. We can see outside, so that's not a big deal. I'm gonna put gear down in here, plus 15. There we go. So as you can see there, the runway there, okay, that's why I start to descend, okay, visually. Beautiful. Soon we're gonna be established on the localizer. 170 knots. Here we go. That's what we've got in there. Continue send visually in there. Here we go. Localize. Everything is fine. Beautiful. We put flap 30, and we fly the 150 knots. We get established on the localizer, and we follow the glide slope all the way down to the threshold. Okay, beautiful. So flop of 30, speed break is arm, landing gear is down, everything is down complete, very nice. Let's do 22 knots of headwind, so we fly 150 knots, we try to keep that. Alright, over the threshold, so go around, flaps 15, set ground thrust, gear up, positive rate, very good. So 15 degrees of pitch. Now, next thing, 700 feet, heading select, 2 radio from its approach, and we go with flap 5, 1000 feet, we start turn right, here we go. So we are retracting the flaps to flaps 5, continue climb. With the aircraft decelerating around 1000 feet per minute. Then we're gonna go flap 1. And then we can go flap up. So flap up, now we're gonna accelerate to 210 knots, level off at 2000 feet. Here we go, 210 knots, start to reduce the thrust a little bit, still pitch up, because remember guys, on the 737 when you reduce the thrust, the aircraft will pitch down, so you need to actually correct that moment, okay? Okay, 2000 feet are in there. Nice, we level off at 2000 feet, we keep 210 knots. And 254 is our downwind track. Okay, once we get 254, we'll roll the wings and we do straight level flights, 200, 210 knots, 2000 feet. Then in this case, now you should again do the after takeoff checks, plan for the fuel, check the fuel. Now we've got 4.5, so it's a lot of fuel. Do the PA as well because you need to inform the passengers in real life, okay? And so, all right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this short flight and practice with a go-around. Okay, guys, if you have any questions about go-around, just leave a comment below and I will help you out. Okay, also, you can go to paloclimb.com where you can subscribe for free palo training content. I wish you a great day and I'll see you on the next one.